Salvation is the indicator for the work of ministry. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 11 and 12. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. The word perfecting means to fit to function. To fit the saints to function. The word saints refers to believers. We are the called out ones. The saints or the called out ones or the believers are being fitted for the work of ministry. Believers are being fitted for the work of ministry. Once a man is born again, that man has a call to ministry. Every child of God has a call to ministry. Earlier on, Brother Paul was talking about this calling. He used the word calling. Look at Ephesians chapter 4 verse 4. There is one body and one spirit. Even as you are called in one hope of your calling. Every believer is called. Every believer has a calling. Every child of God is not dependent on dreams and visions and thunders and lightning and voices. Once you are saved, once you are born again, you are called. Brother Paul called it the hope of your calling, which he used earlier for what is called salvation, the hope of your calling. Look at Ephesians chapter 1 verse 18. The eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. In the New Testament, the call of God is used for salvation. I repeat. In the New Testament, the call of God is used for salvation. Look at Romans chapter 8 verse 29 and 30. For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Next verse. Oh glory. For moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 24 to further establish that the call of a believer is salvation. But unto them which are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God. 25 and 26. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. 26. For you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty, not many noble are called. You see your calling. Look at 2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 9. Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. That is, in that calling is where we have ministry gifts. In the call of salvation is where we have ministry gifts. I repeat, in the call of salvation is where we have ministry gifts. In Ephesians chapter 4 verse 11 and 12 again. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers. Why? For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. In the book of Acts, the call to ministry was not a special experience. In the book of Acts, the apostles had been chosen by Jesus and they came forth fulfilling what Jesus told them to do. In fact, Brother Paul had an encounter in Acts chapter 9 where Jesus appeared to Paul, who was the Saul of Tarsus. Look at Acts chapter 9 verse 4 to 6. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? Next verse. And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus. I love that introduction. I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. It shall be told thee what thou must do. Jesus also appeared to Ananias and gave Ananias instructions on what to do. Look at Acts chapter 9 verse 11 and 12. And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the street which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus. For behold, he prayeth. Next verse. And had seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight. Again, it was Ananias who ministered to Paul and not Jesus, because God will always use men for men. Look at Acts chapter 9 verse 17 and 18. And Ananias went his way and entered into the house, and putting his hands on him said, Brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest, has sent me that thou mayest receive thy sight and be filled with the Holy Ghost. Next verse. And immediately there fell from his eyes as it had been scales, and he received sight forthwith and arose and was baptized. It should be clear now that the ministry of reconciliation is administered through men. Look up to me, everybody. The ministry of reconciliation is administered through men. In the case of Paul, it was Ananias. Philip received through the apostles. In Acts chapter 6, when hands were laid on Stephen and Philip, that is not when they received the ministry of reconciliation. The ministry of reconciliation had been given to them at the point of their salvation. The laying on of hands was for the stirring up of the gifts. The laying on of hands was for the stirring up of the gifts. Every child of God that is born again was born again with a ministry of reconciliation. And it's not dependent on spectacular experiences. Your call to ministry came at the point of salvation. Now, the next thing is for you to be equipped, which is what training does. He gave some apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, so that the saints can do the work of ministry. That is why Brother Paul will say to Timothy not to neglect the gift that is in him. All right? In 1 Timothy 4:14. In 2 Timothy 1:6, he says, stir up the gift. Stir it up. In John 20:23, Jesus told them, whosoever sins you remit, they are remitted unto them, and whosoever sins you retain, they are retained. Jesus gave the apostles the authority to administer the ministry of reconciliation. So the call of God to people in the book of Acts, we see men through and through ministering the same. There were no special encounters. No special encounters. They were just men who had received salvation administering the same. As I round up, Acts chapter 8 verse 14, 15, 16 and 17. Now, when the apostles which were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of God, they sent unto them Peter and John. Next verse. Who, when they were come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Ghost. Next verse. For as yet he was falling upon none of them. Only they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Look at the next verse. Then laid they their hands on them, and they received the Holy Ghost. Again, they had received salvation earlier before hands were laid on them. If we go on and on, that was the pattern in the book of Acts. Men were saved. Along with salvation came the calling to the ministry of reconciliation. That is so clear that no one received salvation or the call to ministry on their own. Men were involved. Ephesians tells us that we do not in any way be tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine. When we are taught and fed, then we mature to where we begin to supply. He said, by that which every joint supplieth. So every child of God ought to be in ministry supplying. Let me read it as I get ready to pray. Ephesians chapter 4 from verse 11 to 15. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers. Next verse. For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come, all of us, so every child of God, in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Next verse. That we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sly of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. Next verse. But speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. Next verse. From whom the whole body, every child of God, the whole body, fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth. Every joint supplieth. So every believer ought to be supplying ministry. Look at 1 Timothy 4:14. Neglect not the gift that is in thee. So every child of God has a gift in him. The gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy, with the laying on of the hands of the presbytery. The word presbytery refers to elders, which means the ministry gifts, the elders in the local church, are to mature believers in their callings. We have a responsibility to mature believers in their callings. And like I always say, ministry, therefore, is a fruit of spiritual growth. You are called at salvation. The pastor is called to mature you and bring ministry out of you by teaching and training. By that which every joint in the body ought to supply for the overall functioning and effectiveness of the body of Christ. So no child of God has an excuse. Every believer is called to ministry. You are called to ministry at the point of salvation. It is not dependent on visions, dreams, thunder, and voices. It is dependent on the fact that you are born again. Therefore, you have a ministry and you must fulfill your ministry. Say to Archippus, take it to yourself and see to it that you fulfill your ministry. Every child of God has a ministry to fulfill. And I declare over you tonight, you will fulfill that ministry and you will not be ashamed at the coming of Jesus. I repeat, you will fulfill that ministry and you will not be ashamed at the coming of Jesus. Stand on your feet. Let's pray tonight. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Heavenly Father, we pray for everybody connected to this service in houses, in campuses, online, on television, everybody listening to the sound of my voice on radio. Lord, I ask that this reality will dawn on your people, that they may walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful unto every good work, that your people will strive to see to it that they fulfill the ministry which they have received received of the Lord Jesus. And I thank you for answered prayer. And I decree that men and women are being raised all over the blue marble planet, armed with the truth of the gospel, equipped with the realities of Christ, to make known to our world the mysteries of Christ. And we thank you that the word is growing, disciples are being raised, ministers are being equipped, and the gospel of Christ is taking over the entire world. So we give you praise. Thank you for the blessing tonight. In Jesus' precious name, and every believer says a powerful amen.